In this part, we'll discuss about secondary growth which is taking place in the cortical region. So this is secondary growth in cortical region, or as we discussed in the previous part, it is also known as extrastellar. Extrastellar secondary growth. And the reason why it is known as extrastellar is because it is outside the endodermis part. Now what happens here? In this secondary growth, some cells of the parenchymatous cortex, say these cells of parenchymatous cortex, they get de-differentiated. And these cells will now form the meristematic zone. That means now they will divide to produce new tissue. So here the parenchymatous cells have undergone a change which is known as de-differentiation. De-differentiation basically means that a permanent tissue can come back into the division mode. When after division, it becomes permanent, we call it differentiation. That means it gets mature and specialized. If it comes back to that original property of division, then the process is reversed. We call it de-differentiation. So now there is a strip of meristematic tissue form. Now where is that strip form? This is here. And if we make this structure here, this is the cortical region. So in this cortical region, we find a complete ring of meristem which has developed. We have drawn only a section, but this is in the form of a complete ring. So this is known as cork cambium, and it is in the form of a ring. Cork cambium is again a meristem. It would divide to produce new cells. It produces new cells on the outer side. These new cells, they are parenchymatous cells. These parenchymatous cells are loosely arranged right now. And after they are formed, some cells undergo deposition of suberin. So now here, suberin gets deposited in the cell wall. Suberin is a substance which is impervious to gases and water. So now what is happening is, these parenchymatous cells, in their cell wall, suberin deposition takes place. Suberin is impervious to water. So if there is a layer formed where there is suberin deposition, no gaseous exchange can take place and there would be no diffusion or osmosis. So some cells, they remain parenchymatous. What is outside this? It is happening here. That means outside this right now, there are these parenchymatous cells of cortex region. These are the parenchymatous cells. I've drawn these here. Then there is this hypodermis. In hypodermis, there was pectin deposition. And outside this would be the epidermis. A new layer has been added, a completely new layer. But because of this suberinized cells, suberinization is deposition of suberin. Because of this, the outer cells will slowly die off. Reason? There is no substance which is moving up to them because of this. So after some time, these cells, they will fall off. I'm showing it here. After some time, the structure is going to look like this. These parenchymatous cells will be exposed. I'll draw it a little later once we are done with the inner part also. Now, what happens on the inner side? On the inner side, it produces again parenchymatous cells, normal parenchymatous cells. So, this cork cambium, which was formed from few cells of primary cortex, it became into cork cambium. It gave rise to a layer outside and a layer inside. Outer layer was also parenchyma, but there was deposition of suberin. So, this layer is called cork. The layer of parenchymatous cells where suberin got deposited, it is called cork. Cork does not allow movement of substances through it, nor neither gases nor any substance. And that is why the bottles which contain some special type of liquids which should not react with air, their mouth is closed with cork. Because if cork is placed, then there is no gaseous exchange possible, and the liquid can also not come out of that bottle. The inner part is known as cortex. But this cortex is formed later, so we will call it secondary cortex. So there are three layers which are there. The cork cambium is there, cork is there, and secondary cortex is there. Cork cambium is also known as phellogen. The cork is known as phellum, and the secondary cortex is known as phellodur. And these three things together, or these three layers together, that is cork, cork cambium, and secondary cortex together, are known as peridur. So now again, there are layers which are added. That means if we are talking about this, then outside this, there would be cork added. Inside this, there would be secondary cortex. So now there are rings are added of different tissues. Here, secondary phloem ring was added. Secondary xylem ring was added. Here, cork ring is added. Secondary cortex ring is added. So now, after these two secondary groups, how has the primary tissue layers, or how have the primary tissue layers changed? So let us write down this in sequence. Outermost epidermis, we are talking about primary tissue. Then hypodermis, then cortex, then endodermis, then pericycle. After pericycle was primary phloem, then cambium, then primary xylem, and innermost was pith. This was the original primary tissue. Now, after secondary growth, this is primary. After secondary growth, how have these layers changed? Now, secondary growth, if it has just begun, then it is going to be epidermis as it is. Then, or let me write it here so that epidermis comes in front of epidermis. This is secondary growth. Epidermis, hypodermis is going to be still there. Then the little part of primary cortex. So primary cortex. Now there is cork added. So there would be cork. Then cork cambium. Then secondary cortex. After secondary cortex, imagine if secondary cortex is formed here, the primary cortex is still there. So after this, there would be primary cortex, then endodermis, then pericycle. After pericycle, now it's going to be primary phloem, then after primary phloem, it's going to be secondary phloem, then cambium, then secondary xylem, and innermost is going to be primary xylem, and very less pith. less, pith is going to remain. This is secondary growth for a short period of time. Now, if secondary growth continues, then what happens? Because of this cork, the gaseous exchange to the outer cells would be lost. So slowly, these cells will be lost. So I'm removing the cells from one region. So these cells would be lost. From here also the cells would be lost. And these parenchyma cells would only remain here. So now we would see only these parenchyma cells. And this part would be open. The epidermis is going to fall off, hypodermis is going to fall off. So it is going to be all only cork and some loosely arranged parenchyma cell. This structure is known as lenticel. Lenticel is an area now through which gaseous exchange would take place. See, it is all parenchyma. It is all parenchyma. So there would be simple diffusion and osmosis. But because of the cork, the outer cells would fall off. So if secondary growth takes place for a very long period of time, then epidermis would be gone, hypodermis would be gone, and the primary cortex will also be gone. So outermost layer is going to be cork. So if secondary growth continues for a long period of time, outermost is cork. Then cork cambium, then secondary cortex, primary cortex. These things are going to be same. Then endodermis, pericycle, then primary phloem, secondary phloem, cambium, secondary xylem, and primary xylem. No pith. Because if secondary growth continues, the inner part or pith will get crushed because of the primary xylem moving in, and the outer parts would also be lost because of formation of cork. So two places where secondary growth has taken place, one in the vascular region and one in the cortical region. After secondary growth, there are four additional layers which are formed. One layer is of cork, the other layer is of secondary cortex. Inner side, secondary phloem and secondary xylem, these four are added in a ring manner. So when tissue is added in a ring, girth of the plant increases. And in dicot stem, the secondary growth takes place in a very perfect manner. And that is why we started with the structure of dicot stem. As we are talking about dicot stem only, we will discuss about few more things in the next part. That is, what exactly is bark and what is wood. And we would also talk about different types of woods.